Hello, Babs.
Hello, my beautiful daughter.
How are you doing?
Good. I'm doing great. Awesome.
Nice. Welcome
Yeah.
to another episode of Ask Babs.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
As per usual,
As per
we're
usual.
locked in.
So are you Gen Z or Gen this or Gen that? What do you
I
generate?
think we should have people like me who are on the borderline. So I'm borderline. I'm generation borderline.
Okay,
So
so
I border.
you're much more stable now in your way of looking at things, but you could also be dangerous.
Yeah,
You
so
could go persecuting them.
I'm half Gen Z, half millennial. I'm just border. I'm just, yeah, in
Aha.
between the two.
So you're Zinelli. How do you call you?
Yes, Zillennial.
Zillennial. That's what I was
Exactly.
looking for. Yeah. Okay.
Clap for your people who know these terms. You
Thank
must
you.
educate yourself.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so as we've seen, there's an uprising in our country.
Yes.
And not just our country, actually.
Yeah.
It's all over the world. Young
Yeah.
people are really changing the old-fashioned way of doing things. So currently in Kenya, young people are protesting the finance bill.
Yeah.
Because of a few things here and there that are just not in line with maybe what we think would be beneficial for everyone. So I guess what we need to know is how to go about this. What's profitable for us in the end, because we want to bring change, but at the same time, there's a way to do things which we are not refusing. Just maybe that guidance on how to go about.
So first thing, we need to appreciate the fact that overtaxation is not good. No country ever prospered by taxing people heavily.
Okay.
Not even kings in the Bible. I'll give you an example. King Solomon heavily taxed people. When he died, people actually breathed a sigh of relief. And his son, called Rehoboam, took over power. And people asked him to lower the taxes. Hey, take these burdens off us, make the burdens lighter. Well, he didn't listen. So he lost 12 tribes out of the, no, 10 out of the 12 tribes because of heavy taxation. The same thing was seen in the life of King Saul. Of King what? King Saul? Yeah, King Saul. King Saul not only heavily taxed people, but enslaved them. Even though the Israelites wanted a king, they got a king that heavily taxed them. Took practically everything. He took people's properties and all that. And his end was not good. So we have to appreciate the fact that though taxation is how government raises revenue, it must not be too much. It must be in a way, it must be done in a way that is an incentive to business. If you tax people too highly, certain companies might leave your country. And these companies employ people and pay
Yes.
taxes.
Yes.
So you actually lose out by overtaxing, you lose out on the tax collection itself. It needs to be a delicate balance. Next thing, when young people realize that as a result of taxation, their lives are in jeopardy, they have all the rights to go to the streets, they have all the rights to use their technological devices to express their displeasure. The only thing I would say is that they should not be disrespectful or dishonorable. We applaud the fact that Gen Zs are peaceful. There's no wanton destruction, there's no pilfering, and stuff like that. They're just expressing themselves.
Yes.
But you've got to realize that your mouth is your biggest device for charting the course of your life. And if out of your mouth proceeds words that are corrupt, words that don't build, you can protest without insulting. You can picket without name calling. You can strike without pulling anyone down, without traducing, besmirking. There are different words we can use.
Even though the leaders themselves might be even calling names.
Yes.
Yes.
The fact that your father uses foul language doesn't mean that foul language is standard language. Do you see? I'm talking as a minister of the gospel. And I'm talking also as a politician, because one of these findings, I'll run for president of the country. I made the announcement. They arrested me promptly. So young people don't think, we've been through the things you've been through. I was arrested 4 times, stayed in custody, you know, slept on those cold floors. Because of saying I wanted to be president of this country. I was 32 then, borderline again, right?
Yeah.
You see, so don't be disrespectful, because you guys, Gen Zs, are easy to teach. You love knowledge, you love information, because that's really your cup of tea, information, communication. So learn. You can learn to be polite, but very firm.
Okay.
Yeah. If you study my life, I've never insulted any politician or taken on any politician in a way that appeared disrespectful, even when one of them got me arrested and created what they call the media machinery. This, let's unleash media machinery against this guy. Let's attack his faith. Mm. I never said negative things back to that particular politician or any other. I just stuck to my principles. And for that reason, I am where I am. Mm-hmm. I didn't go down. Mm-hmm. I'm still planning to be president. It's just I'm raising a young family now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't want to be in politics, which requires you to be out hours on end, campaigning and doing all manner of things when children are young. Mm-hmm. As soon as this guy is a young adult, then you'll see me on the ballot, running for president. And these Gen Zs, well, will be my constituents. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this lovely constituency. Mm-hmm. I'll be running in your constituency as a president. Okay.
Nice.
Yeah.
So you've mentioned something about how we can be firm, but also polite.
Yes.
So many would see that as weakness. Mm-hmm. Leaders normally interpret that as, you see, they can't even do anything because we're leaders. Just because you don't name call and you don't like maybe outrightly threaten them or something like that. Mm-hmm. So how can, because what people want across all generations really is mm-hmm. power. Mm-hmm. Like we're being listened to, expressing something, and it's being taken into consideration. Mm-hmm. How can we now be firm and polite, just like you think?
Now, there is no place and there is no book, there's no standard mm-hmm. that supports the notion that you have to be rude to have power.
Okay.
You have to use coarse language and jesting to mm-hmm. have power. Mm-hmm. People who do that are limited in knowledge. That's all they know. They think that because that's all they know, mm-hmm. then that's all there is to know in that area, and that's all there is to use to get their end result. Mm-hmm. Listen, expand your knowledge. Then you'll find there are easier ways of achieving the very same thing. Mm-hmm. We are commanded by the Bible to honor all authority and to pray for them. Mm-hmm. Some of these people are literally cursing authorities that we've been commanded by God to pray for. For that reason, the curse comes upon you much worse. Because children have been commanded by God to respect their elders. Rise up when a person with gray hair comes. Stand in respect and honor. That's one thing I notice a lot of Gen Zs don't have. Respect for authority or respect for elders. Respect and honor for parents. I'm not saying that you respect people because they're right. You respect people because of their right.
So it's not a matter of respect is a two-way
street. No, nothing is ever a two-way street. There's nothing that's a two-way street. You do your bit, and your bit will pave the path for you. Nothing is given. Things are taken. So you can be the most popular person in the country and still not lead the country. Because you didn't take power, you thought it would be given to you. True. So respect is also taken, not given.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
So a young person shouldn't say, my mama should respect me so that I can respect her back. A wise young person should respect because of the benefits of respect, not because someone else is respecting you. You don't say, I will eat because you're eating. I won't eat because you're not eating. You eat because of the benefits of nutrition. So respect and honor have their benefits. And even in societies of the wicked, even drug lords, a fundamental rule for any society to work is that protocol is respected. Yeah. So that you can do if you expand your vocabulary and your knowledge, and if you read a lot more books, maybe watch a lot more videos that have to do with power, politics,
governance.
Yeah, governance. Yeah, be a bit more focused now, now that you've got into the political land, what do you call it, landscape. Read, focus a bit more. Find out how great revolutionaries operated. I'll also appreciate that most of them were killed. So get ready for that as well, that most revolutionaries, most changers, liberators never live to see what they fought for. So get ready to pay the price, and then you will succeed. It's as simple as that. Well, it's not as simple as that. It's as hard as that. Yes.
Wow.
I agree.
Let's stew in that. I think we should take a minute to just tune.
Tell me, now that you're the borderline between Gen Z and
Millennial.
What is your opinion about all this? Let me turn the tables now and start interviewing you. She's the one who's supposed to interview me. But I love to hear these guys. They're so lovely. They're so wonderful. They're so free-spirited. And they're so curious. And they invent witty things. And especially, I love the disruption, the way you walk into a place and disrupt the way everything works. Yeah. Do you approve of how your colleagues are handling this matter? Or do you agree with the way they handle the matter?
I'd say mostly yes. Because, first of all, I'm so proud of my generation for not looting.
That's really good. That's really good.
Actually, it's been about... You know, they've been saying no stones, just phones.
Wow.
Yes.
Wait a minute. I love that.
Yes.
No stones, just phones. Nice.
Social media and use of gadgets. We're not throwing stones at anyone.
Yeah.
We're either throwing our intelligence at you or, you know, so what matters is how they will respond. So to that end, I'm really proud of us. Because we're not fighting. We don't even want war. We just want to be listened to and be included at the decision-making tables. Yes.
Now, being included is a tall order and quite difficult. Because to be included, you have to take it.
Yes.
You will not be included.
Yes.
You'll have to force your way in there.
Yes. So I guess this what's happening right now,
Is the first step
to forcing your way. Forcing without violence.
Yes, of course.
Yes.
Do you remember Steve Mbiko? There's a guy called Steve Mbiko. A lot of young people might not remember him. He was a freedom fighter in South Africa. Steve Mbiko. So I don't know how the second name is pronounced, really. And the gentleman was arrested for... stoking agitation, and asking people to fight. So he was taken to the court, and he was being charged for causing violence. So he was asked, why is it that you are inciting your people to fight, thereby causing violence? And he told a prosecutor or whoever was cross-examining him, said, there is war between us, you and me. We are both fighting right now, but I see no violence. So when you talk about phones and no stones and stuff like that, intellectual approach to these things, I remember that gentleman. He was a young man, by the way. Incidentally, he died because he didn't listen to his wife. You know, he was told not to leave his hometown, almost like he was under house arrest of sorts. But he defied that order and went driving to, I think, Johannesburg, and the process was shot dead. So the wife warned him and said, say, don't go there, they're going to kill you. This freedom fighting that you involved in can take your life, say, don't go there. So he defied the wife, and women have this instinct and this intuition given to them by God, and he died.
Wow.
But he was a great, great man, very intelligent.
Yeah.
So if our young people can learn that even taking the seat of power or being included at the table of decision making, that in itself means knowing gatekeepers.
Yes.
There's protocol everywhere.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
There is the stages and steps towards getting power, which I think is what the young people must now start learning. Read historical books.
Yes.
Read the Bible, the best political book you can ever lay your hands on.
Wow.
Yeah? Yeah, because nobody can defeat you if you're a person who's given to Bible study. No one can defeat your reason, your intelligence, because it's divine. It's supernatural.
Wow.
You see? Now, if you're not a Christian, that's okay. I'm talking about Christianity because that's what I've been called to talk about. And you may quickly say, well of course, then if you become president, will you force everybody to become Christian? No, Jesus is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He's not forced everybody to be a Christian.
Yes.
But he's King of Kings, Lord of Lords.
Yes.
So pluralism is part and parcel of the game. Later you'll answer to deity, not to me. Yeah.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Honestly, let's just take a moment.
You take a moment.
Yes. This has been nice.
Thank you.
Yes, we will. As young people, we still have many questions, many things that need to be answered.
Yeah.
So we will still seek for guidance.
Yes, but I want you to know you have my support, 100%.
Yes.
In whichever way, in training, capacity building, and ultimately in funding.
Ooh.
Yeah, we shall put some funds aside for well-meaning, focused, talented young people who want change. Yeah, change. You have to agitate for change, which won't come. As for the old guard, people who follow tribe as the launching pad for political expediency, time is up. It is up. It doesn't matter how deeply entrenched you are in this thing. The moment you get a group of people who don't identify by any tribe, they are just one huge tribe of people who don't discriminate anyone. They don't discriminate through religion or what. They are just one group of people.
Who speak one voice.
You should be on their side. If you're on the opposite side, it will be an avalanche that will completely overflow you and sweep you into smithereens. You don't want that in politics, do you?
No. No one wants that even in life.
Yeah.
So, everyone who's watched this video, listen to this again. The old generation and the young generation alike, because there's a lot to learn.
Yes.
Right now, in the future, and also from the past.
Yes.
Yeah, the mistakes that the older generation made.
Yeah.
So much to learn. So with that, I say thank you very much.
Most welcome.
Up until the next episode.
Uh-huh.
See you. Bye.
Bye-bye.